Hello everyone, I am Mohammed Nadeemuddin and I have secured an All India rank of 656 in the Civil Services Examination 2017. I would like to convey you that my optional subject was Political Science and International Relations. In my optional subject this year, I have secured marks of 304 marks in totally. In paper 1, I have secured 152 marks. Also, in paper 2, I have secured 152 marks. So we will talk. I stand here before you to talk about the more about the paper and what changes and improvements that I did in this particular subject, because I remember in this was my second attempt. In my first attempt, I had scored only 222 marks. So there has been a significant jump from the score of my political science in my first attempt and in my second attempt. So basically there are two papers. In paper 1, it deals with political theory and political science, whereas the paper 2 talks about international relations. The reason for why I took political science and international relations as optionals is that although I am graduated as a civil engineer in the year 2014, when I referred to the syllabus of political science and international relations, I realized that there was a lot of overlap in terms of essay, in terms of GS paper 1, GS paper 2, as well as in the paper of ethics. So that was the sole reason I took this option subject, and in the beginning I did not have any interest in the subject. However, when I started to read more about this subject, I developed an interest towards the subject. So as I mentioned that I would like to deal a crash course on the political science and international relations subject, as well as I would like to share certain strategies and key points that you have to keep in your mind while you're preparing for this examination, and that would help you to attain a score of, you know, more than 300. We all know that the competition is going very huge, so it is very important to score more marks in the optional subject. Before beginning your preparation, it is very, very necessary and important that you always keep a printout, a hard copy printout of the syllabus with you. Please go through the syllabus thoroughly, understand what all the topics are there in both paper 1 and paper 2. This would help you to remain within the boundaries of the syllabus, because if you do not see the syllabus, you may get lost with the preparation. The second most important thing that is to be considered, taken consider, is that at the end of the day, we have to restrict our material. Do not increase your material so much so that tomorrow when you have examination, it becomes very difficult for you to revise and consolidate the things. The second important thing is restrict your resources to minimum. If you restrict your material, it will be very, very easy for you to consolidate them at a later stage. Consolidation becomes very, very easy. Also, the third most important thing that the aspirants have to keep in their mind is that if you are just mere reading the notes or test books, it will just lead to a passive learning. Whereas if you are learning through question answer format, that would make a more active learning. So ensure that you parallelly, when you are reading a test book, parallelly you also refer to the toppers or best answer booklets available online. Those who have written good answers on political science and international relations in the question papers of previous years, try to see their answers, how they have written. So a very important thing is that read also in question answer format. This would make active learning. coming to the next important thing is that it's very, very important to make your own micro or notes. Now, why do I say that? I realized in my first attempt that I had read from so many different sources. I did not consolidate them. I did not prepare my separate notes from whatever the topics that I am reading from a test book. When I realized, when I was appearing for the first time, there was so much to cover, there was so much to revise, but I couldn't revise them properly. In my second attempt, what I did, I made notes to the point, crisp, and included every aspect of that particular topic. This helped me to revise many times easily and quickly before my examination. So always ensure that whatever you study, be it from newspaper, be it from online resources, be it from any textbook, always keep your notes separately. I would like to add another thing when you are preparing your short notes. Ensure that do not make notes so much bulkier that it would also add up a lot to your existing material. Ensure my way of preparing notes was very different. I'll tell you. I used to take a A4 page. And I used to divide that page in 3 sections. And then I used to make my notes. I used to start from here, then jump over here, then jump over here. The beauty of using such approach is that at the end of the day, when your syllabus is over, you will be having less number of pages. That also psychologically benefits a lot. And this would help you to revise very, very efficiently and very quickly just before the examination. Another important thing is that this exam is all about management. Now, what do I mean by that management? I have secured 304 marks. It's purely because how I managed well as per the demand of the examination. There are certain mechanical works that you have to do. Refer the syllabus, find all the key terms in the syllabus, and make a good repository of opening lines, that is a good introduction for every topic. Example, liberalism. Make a good introduction of liberalism, and that too it should appear as if a definition of high standard. You have to make a separate copy and you have to make off all the key terms, be it liberalism, be it socialism, be it Marxism, fascism, everything. Make a management through repository of good opening lines. Another advantage of making such repository of good opening lines is that if you see a question in that examination, you don't have to think to create an introduction. The introduction will be already there in your mind and you can straight away start your answer. If a question comes on post-behavioralism, you must know the definition of behavioralism. The moment you know the definition of behavioralism, you can immediately start. So ensure that you have a repository of each term mentioned in the syllabus or the opening lines of them. Secondly, for the beginners students, I would like to connect from this point. My second point is that you have to refer, for especially the aspirants who are just beginning. Most of the time we don't know how to write an answer. Maybe we may be having a lot of conceptual clarity on a particular topic, but the problem is most of the candidates, they suffer as to how should we write a better answer. So my advice would be, if you would like to know how to write a better answer, you have to see others' answer. In my first attempt, I did not refer to others' answers and I end up scoring only 225 marks, around 225 marks in my first attempt, including both the papers. I realized that there is some problem with my answer writing. I'm not able to introduce my answer properly. I'm not able to bring coherence to my answer. There is a problem in the structure. I'm not able to conclude my answer. When I started referring to others' answers, which includes many, and I did my own answer writing practice, I developed a skill as to how I should begin an answer, including conclusion, including body part, and also how I should end an answer with an optimistic conclusion. So it's very, very important to refer the solve answer booklets of the toppers who have written in the political science and international relations. And the very, again, very important thing is that we have to understand the demand of the exam, number one, number two, as well as the question. What type of questions are being asked, it is very, very important to know. You will get them only when you refer previous year papers. The moment when you see the previous year papers, you will understand, especially for paper 2. In the international relations, almost about 50% of the topics asked are of static in nature, and remaining 50% of the topics, around 50% of the topics, are dynamic in nature. When you go through the previous year papers, you will realize that the dynamic portions, they generally ask the current affairs that are in majorly in news for about 1 or 2 years. We must give less focus to those topics which have been in the news for about, let us say, 10 years back, 20 years back, 30 years back. Not necessary. Especially when it comes to paper 2, you must understand what is relevant in the last 1-2 years. Especially, special focus has to be given to those topics. When you are making a repository, what I used to do was, for every topic, I used to mention the scholars. I used to write down all the scholars associated with it. Scholars. Example, in the topic of justice, I used to mention about John Rawls and his all the those critical scholars of the above theory. This is part. Secondly, try to relate that particular topic with additional any example. Current affairs. Example, in this year's paper, in the 2017 civil services examination, a question was asked on Aristotle's theory of revolution, and which is very closely related to theory of equality. After answering that question, I mentioned about the crisis in various countries like Syria, the crisis in various countries of Middle East. It is because of the perceived inequality among the masses. That is how you connect with your theory part. So you have to make a repository in your introduction, in your notes itself, all the scholars mentioned and their views and the critical scholars of that particular view and examples, events, current affairs, etc. You have to make a separate repository of this. Please ensure that your syllabus, your preparation of optional subject is done before the preliminary examination itself. Always cover your syllabus and notes before preliminary examination. It's very, very important. What happens is that more often than not, students don't generally cover the syllabus before prelims and they wait for after the preliminary examination. But remember that there is a huge competition. If you cover the syllabus once and prepare the notes, all you have to do is after preliminary examination is just to revise. So there is no time. So ensure that this you definitely do this. Also, one thing I realize is that in my first attempt, I had neglected many parts of the syllabus. Like if a topic I am not comfortable with it, I used to neglect it. But don't do that. Every topic in the syllabus is very, very important. In a similar manner, if there is paper 1, there will be two parts, paper part A and part B. In both, you must be thorough with both the parts, because at the end of the day, when the questions will be asked and choices will be given, we should be in a position to write at least the 3 answers from part A and part B, etc. So ensure that you have a good command on all the topics. Do not leave any topic at the mercy of the question paper. Do not leave. So this is very again important. I would also like to talk about more about the writing answers separately. As I mentioned, answer writing again plays very, very important role. You must learn the art of answer writing, especially when it comes to optional subject. This has to be learned, because in GS generally, if even if you write a mechanical answer, you may fetch marks, but here there has to be more coherence, there has to be proper structuring. You have to compulsorily follow introduction, body and conclusion format with a good introduction with a good conclusion. This has to be kept in mind. Now, for a beginner candidates, the most important aspect which they fail, which they suffer, which they have a lot of problem is that they, as I mentioned, that they find difficulty in answer writing. Like what I did, in a similar manner, I would request you to refer others' answers. Toppers, best copies. If, suppose, let us say today you have studied political theory or a topic on justice, on John Rawls' theory of justice. You have studied this, but if you don't know how to write a good answer, kindly refer this and make a repository of that. Make a repository. You would be already preparing a repository of introduction and conclusion. By doing this, you will get a hold of answer writing. Also, when you refer this, you will understand that this is how I have to write an answer. Secondly, you have to write an answer by yourself. The inertia which prevents us for answer writing has to go in this examination, because it is very important for us to score 300 marks and above if you want to get your desired service. So write an answer by yourself. You must join a test series available in the market. There is a saying in English that what's not measured cannot be improved. So if you are not measuring your performance, how would you improve your performance? So thereby test series play a very, very important role. Take a test series for about, let us say, 3 hours, and know how much you can write in 3 hours. At the same time, how much coherence you can bring in your answers. Secondly, how much you will score in your test series. That will definitely boost your confidence. I remember in my first attempt in 2016 civil services examination, in my test series I used to get only 50 marks out of 250, sometimes 70 marks out of 250, or maximum 80 marks out of 250. I had never scored more than 80 marks in my civil services examination 2016 test series. Whereas after doing the improvements, I started scoring 115 out of 250, then 125 out of 250, and last I scored till 135 out of 250. This when I joined a test series. So my request would be to if there is any test series available in the market, do join, and also don't wait for the preliminary examination to come, or don't wait to make sure that you are clearing the prelims. You have to join a test series before itself. The best part is test series will come up with a timetable, so that you will be given a particular specific portion of the syllabus to cover in number of days, which you can cover in so many number of days. Hence, you will yourself tend to get a schedule. So you will tend to make your schedule, and it will also help you to cover the syllabus thoroughly even before writing the preliminary examination. If you do this, and again after joining the prelim, if you join again the test series, you will be in a competition. It is very, very important to take little extra efforts than the crowd if you wish to get selected in this examination. Secondly, as I mentioned this part, I would like to once again reiterate that a good opening lines plays a very, very important role in impressing the evaluator. How? I will tell you an example. In the last year, in the 2017 main examination, there was a question in paper 1 on National Commission on Minorities. How did I begin this answer? How did I begin? A question was asked on National Commission on Minorities. I began by saying what Mahatma Gandhi had said, that a civilization can be judged by the way it treats its minorities. Can you imagine the beauty of this statement? A civilization can be judged by the way it treats its minorities. It is straight away hitting to this topic. So this is how I began my answer. I can give you another example. A question was asked on NPT, that is Nuclear Proliferation Treaty. Nuclear Proliferation Treaty. So I began, how did I begin? There, I began by a statement which was said by Ikuo Ito. This person is a former mayor of the city of Nagasaki. And as we know that Nagasaki was the city where the nuclear bomb was dropped. So he was the city, he was the mayor of that particular city. What he has mentioned is that nuclear weapons are incompatible with humanity. So I had started my question on Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty by saying what Ikuo Ito had said about nuclear weapons. It is very, very much significant and relevant statement by said by a person who himself had suffered because of the nuclear weapon. So you must start something with this catchy and good opening lines. Once you have written a good opening line, you can directly jump to the body part and connect it with your answer. Once you are done with the body part, when it comes to conclusion, in the body part, there are three aspects. First, you have to describe the central idea. Describe the central idea. Secondly, you have to mention the scholars of the particular topic. It's very, very important and relevant that you put the scholars, the name of the scholars associated with that theories. Because the thing is, if you do not mention this and you simply straight away write your answer, your answer will not be of so much weight. So you have to mention the scholars, number one. Number two, their criticism by other scholars. Criticism by other scholars, if it is there. Number three, you have to do cross-pollination. And what is cross-pollination? I can use in paper 1 any theory, let us say if paper 1 any theory of paper 1 part A theory, and write mix in paper 1 part B. Example, if you see the syllabus in paper 1 part B, there is something called as Dalit perspective. Dalit perspective of Indian National Movement. This comes under part B of paper 1. How can I relate something of part paper 1 part A? Is that I can say that this is very similar to Gramsci's concept of Gramsci has given the theory of hegemony, and similar to Gramsci's concept of subaltern class. So this is how you have to correlate, including, and this cross-pollination also means that if something, a theory is there of paper 1, you can also relate with paper 2. The more you do the linkage, the more you mention, do the cross-pollination, this will be really appreciated by the examiner or the evaluator. If a question, I will give you another example, if a question comes on equality, Imagine if a question comes on equality, and this equality chapter has been covered comprehensively by Dworkin, who has given equality of capability. No, I'm sorry. He is given equality of resources. Dworkin has given equality of resources, which I will cover in my successive chapters. Amartya Sen has given equality of capability approach, basically. This is more means oriented. This is more ends oriented. If a question is asked on the concept of equality, I'll definitely mention both the scholars, and also I will also mention Aristotle's view on equality. I'll mention this. So this is how you have to link with the different, all the concepts you have to link, which includes the cross-pollination in between the papers, within the papers, everything. And always ensure that when you are seeing others' answers, whenever you find anything new, kindly note it down in a separate sheet. If you have read, let us say, a topic on John Rawls' theory of justice, John Rawls' theory of justice from your notebook or any textbook, and if you are seeing the other answer, other person's answer, who has written on a similar topic, but he has written something very different. If he has written something very different, something unique, try to collect in a separate sheet, and you can use it while you are writing your own answer. It's very, very important that since we know that examination paper 1 of political science, it is for 3 hours, and another paper 2, it's again for 3 hours. Please keep in mind that when you are giving any test, when you have joined the test series, write in exact exam simulation manner. Do not write in something as 5 hours or take your break in between the examination. Don't do that. When you are sitting for examination, consider when you are taking any test series, consider that as a UPSC examination itself. It will help you to prepare in a more better manner, and you will also realize where your weaknesses are. I have seen a lot of candidates who take the test not in a time format manner, but they will write as much as long as they want, for maybe 4 hours, 5 hours, or they will take some times in between the break. But I realized that this approach will not work. In my second attempt, I had completely given focus to more exam orientation. So whenever I used to write a test, I used to ensure that I give 3 hours properly for the test series without any disturbance. Lastly, in addition to this, I will mention, whenever you are writing the main examination, actual examination, ensure that at least 10 to 15 days before, you take in exact 2 papers together. As in, you write the test series of paper 1, paper 2, comprehensive test series exactly in the same time, maybe something as 9 to 12 PM, paper 1, immediately after 2 hours, 2 to 5 PM, another paper 2. This exercise you have to do even before writing the actual examination. The best part about doing such exercise is that when you will take the actual examination, you will not feel any difference. It will be a very normal and a casual examination for you. So this is how we will prepare our mind as well as hand, because writing for about 6 hours and in a subject like optional subject, it is a challenging task in itself. But if you write it more before the examination, it will be a normal thing for you. Secondly, the very important thing, while writing the examination, actual examination, because the choices will be given to you, you have to, out of the 8 questions given, you have to answer 5 questions. There will be total 8 questions that will be given to you, and out of those 8, you have to answer 5 questions. And within these questions, there will be another sub questions. Two questions under these five questions will be compulsory, and the remaining three that you have to decide from the remaining questions. To ensure that you decide the questions properly, and once you have taken a decision, don't come back, because you may have started the paper again by thinking that the next question you will not be able to write properly. Then don't switch. So please ensure that when you are deciding to write an answer, ensure that you have a good command and select them very wisely. You must also revise thoroughly the good intros and conclusion for every answer. Also, when you're writing the conclusion, ensure that the conclusion is very forward looking in itself, and it is very open, it's very optimistic. Do not write conclusion that is pessimist in nature. Ensure that while you are writing the answer, you have written enough number of thinkers, scholars related with current affairs, and also the criticism of that. So you have to prepare priorly for achieving this. Secondly, my preparation has been very, very simple. As I mentioned in the beginning itself, I had restricted a lot of sources. I had restricted my book list. So the sources that I followed, I can tell you. But more than book, what is more important is in this examination is how well you manage, how well you consolidate, how well you make your notes very effective. So number one, I started with NCERT. There is a book on political theory. I had read this book. In addition to this, for paper 1, I had read Subraranjan's classroom notes. This you have to note because the notes are very good. Second and third, my source was for paper 1. There is a book of political ideologies. Written by Andrew Haywood. I had read this book. But the beauty of, the beauty of this subject is that you don't have to read any book completely. Of course, you have to read this full, but the remaining books that I will mention, you don't have to read any book completely, but you have to just read them very selectively. You have to make a note of your syllabus and ensure that what all topics are there in the syllabus that only you read. Please confine yourself within the boundaries of the syllabus and do not go beyond your syllabus. Secondly, after this part, another book is by political theory, which his name is Political Theory, which is written by O.P. Gauba. Again, this book also you have to read it very selectively. You don't have to read full book, and whatever you find good thing about these books, kindly make notes. You have to make notes in such a manner that you don't have to revisit these books again in order to know more about them. So ensure that when you read them, whatever you find relevant, important, kindly make notes and be selective. And this is for part A. For part B of paper A, this is for paper 1. I'm saying for paper 1, part A. For part B, I was again very much restrictive. I had read Subraranjan's MAM notes. This is very important. Secondly, along with this, Spectrum, the Modern India Spectrum could help to you to some extent. Spectrum's Modern India, because the topics like Indian National Movement, various phases of National Movement, peasant struggles, tribal struggles, all this could be covered from Spectrum Modern India. Also, you could read selectively the book B.L. Faria. This you have to do, selective reading, as I'm mentioning. In addition to this, for paper 1 plus you, as I mentioned, I am reiterating this again and again, ensure that you refers in addition to this, you have to see the question bank, question answer bank. The more you solve the different number of questions, the more expertise you will get on this subject, and the more better you will realize as per the demand of the question. And this is whole for this was the only source for me as far as paper 1 is concerned. I remember that in my first attempt I had got 135 marks, in my second attempt I had got 152 marks. I personally dedicate my this improvement to the test series that I had joined, and also the more than this, this is just a passive learning, and this will make an active learning. This is more active learning, this is more passive learning. Also with this you have to see previous year papers. This was for paper 1, and paper 2 also I will tell. When it comes to paper 2, almost I would say there is a 50-50% of the static portion is there. You have some certain static portion, 50% is you have some certain dynamic portion. This papers requires you to be more clever and be more selective in what you study, because I remember in my first attempt, that is CAC 2016, I had got in this paper only 92 marks out of 250. I had got this. However, in CSC Civil Service Examination 2017, I had got 152 out of 250. So there has been a significant jump of marks, about 60 marks I have improved. 60 marks I have improved by adopting certain strategies and certain doing my preparation as per the demand of the examination. So this is very important. Today I would also like to share about paper 2, what as to how I improved my marks. Again, almost the same thing is there. When it comes to paper 2, there are two parts. Paper 2, again there are two parts. Part A, Part B. In this part, you have comparative politics. And various theories of international relations. In this part you have the India's relation with others. India's relation with other countries and few other topics like foreign policy, etc. You have this. So what I did, the basic I covered through Subraranjan ma'am's notes. In addition to this, what I did was, there is again book, very very beautiful and a very very good book, Global Politics. Written by again Andrew Haywood. This is the same scholar who has also written Political Ideologies. So you have to refer the sole book for Global Politics. Again, the beauty of this book is that you don't have to read completely, only as per the syllabus. You have to refer the syllabus, what all topics are there, you have to read that particular topics. After this, once you are done with the Global Politics, ensure that you make notes out of this. Notes so much so that such that you don't have to refer this book again. Or take out all the important things, take out all the essence of the topics, take out all important definitions, take out all the keywords and the phrases, exact phrases said by a particular person. In every chapter, in the beginning itself, there will be phrases said by important people. So you have to pick this. In addition to this, The third, this is first thing, second thing, and the third thing would be, you have to follow the current affairs. Why? Because I remember in the last year they had asked something about Brexit and its implications. They had also asked about Paris Agreement, etc. So we can expect our questions on this particular thing, current affairs, in part A of paper B as well. You have to prepare. And how I used to do that, I'll also tell how as to how I used to cover IR part. Very, very important thing. First, make a note of what all has happened, important thing, in significant improvements in the last 1 or 2 years. It'll be about 10 topics, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 important topics, 10 to 15 important topics. For every topic, do read that article. For every topic, read 2-3 articles. Let us say Brexit is there, type Brexit space The Hindu on Google, Brexit space Indian Express, etc. So read at least 2-3-4 articles, and when you're reading an article on a particular issue, I would suggest you to make notes along with the name of the scholar who has written that article. The important thing is that when you write your answer, and if you mention the scholar's name and his view, it will add more weight to your answer, and your answer becomes very, very dynamic and active. So by that way, you have to ensure that you make a list of all the key important significant events happened, which directly doesn't relate to India. So this will cover part A of paper 2, and write down, make separate notes, short notes of that. So this was along with this, the fourth thing is that answer. See, refers others' answer again. One very the important problem that I faced in paper 2 was, I did not know how to begin the answer. I was facing a lot of trouble in opening the answer. How should I introduce my answer, especially in paper 2. If a question would have asked on climate change, how should my answer be? If a question is asked on terrorism, how should my answer be? So what I did, I started collecting proverbs said by important persons. I can give you an example. There's this topic called terrorism in paper 2 part A. So I had decided that if a question comes on terrorism, I would begin my answer by saying what Malala Yousafzai had said. Because she herself has suffered from terrorism. She has suffered from terrorism, and she says something about terrorism that pen and books are the two tools to beat terrorism. Can you imagine that if you begin the statement of question, any question asked on terrorism, or if you can conclude, let us say if you can conclude by saying what Malala Yousafzai had said, it would really add more weight to your answer, and your answer will be more dynamic. And examiner will really appreciate, because she has, as I mentioned, she has herself suffered from the terrorism. In a similar way, what you have to do, you have to make a repository of all the key terms, as I mentioned for paper 1 as well. Paper 2, you have to make a repository. If I can tell you, there are important topics in paper 2 part A, like security, like power, like globalization, important opening lines. Democracy we have, human rights we have, environment we have, gender justice we have, terrorism, nuclear proliferation we have. So, and also if a question is comes with respect to regionalization of world politics, and we have bodies like ASEAN, we have APEC, we have SAARC, we have NAFTA. I had separate sheet, I had priorly itself decided that if a question comes on ASEAN, this will be my opening line. If a question comes on APEC, this will be my opening line. If a question comes on SAARC, this will be my opening line and also closing line. If you do this exercise, the significance of my reiteration of the same thing again and again is that this is how I actually, along with the content, you have to do this, and this is how I significantly jumped my score from 92 to 152. This appears to be more mechanical, but if you have the content and if you do this exercise along with the name of the scholars, which you have made separate notes. Example, a question I had asked you to read 2-3 articles on Brexit. So while reading an article, see who has written that, write his name and make notes, and who has written that, at least 2-3 scholars for every article. This year, let us say this year, there can be a question on Korean Peninsula, the reunification of Korean Peninsula, because we have seen how the both the leaders of North Korea and South Korea, they came together and they signed an agreement towards peace. We can also get a question of US coming out of P5+1 agreement, that is of with respect to Iran. And we can also expect a question on the ongoing trade war between United States of America as well as China. Read 2-3 articles from online, make a note of who has written that article and his view, at least 2-3 the different views of that article, and relate with the theories of international relations. Example, once again I can give you, I had read an article written by Suhasini Heather, and the article was on India and its neighbors. She had written that there comes a position where India is neither being feared or loved, and she had compared a scholar named Machiavelli's view with respect to India's situation. So this is how she has done cross-pollination. In a similar manner, we can also do cross-pollination of paper 1 and paper 2. Machiavelli is related to with respect to paper 1, and India and her neighbor is related to paper 2. So she has done that cross-pollination. So you can also do that. Also, this is what is for this is what I did for paper 2 part A. For part B, again a very very important thing. It's very important. India and the topic is India and the world. Paper 2 part B. India and world. I was very much weak in this area in the year 2016 main examination. However, this area I became very strong in this area in my successive next attempt. How I did? First of all, the base has to be covered from Subrahmanyan ma'am's notes. Again, very important. On top of this, it is very important to know that in this area, it is almost the 90% of the topics are dynamic. Only 10% it's static if we see the syllabus. So again, we have to know that what important thing has happened in the last 1 to 2 years with respect to India. If there is a crisis, Maldives crisis, what happened? If there is any crisis, if there is a regime change in Pakistan, new government formation, how it will impact new government of Pakistan and how it will affect India's relations. Make a list of all the topics that you have in the last 1 or 2 years, important significant countries and topics. And for every again, what you can do is for every issue that has happened, read 2-3 articles as I used to do for part A. Take the scholar who has written scholar. Secondly, their views. You have to make a repository of this. In addition to this, if you want good opening lines for country specific, you have to go to mea.government.in this website and type Indo-US. Suppose if you want good lines for Indo-US repository, you type in Indo-US relation. You see the PDF file of Indo-US. If you want some other country, type mea.government.in Indo-Russia. You will get few mechanical opening lines and closing lines that could be possibly used in your answer. Also, sometimes joint statement given by the two leaders, two head of state, could also be very useful. That you can use in your answers. I remember while I was appearing the 2017 examination, there was a visit by Japanese Prime Minister to India. The visit of Japanese Prime Minister to India. The Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe had said a very very significant statement. That statement is: a strong India is in Japan's interest and a strong Japan is in India's interest. See how much powerful this statement is. If you use this statement can be used in any Indo-Japan question if asked in part B of paper 2. Any question comes on Japan, I had decided that I would be using this statement because this is a very powerful and significant statement said by the Japanese Prime Minister with respect to India. So like that, you have to read the joint statement of all the important countries and pick out the important significant statements, and all at the same time ensure that you have prepared your notes very crisp. What I used to do was, I'll tell you what I used to do. I used to, and this is very microscopic thing that I'm gonna tell you, I used to take a page, divide it in three parts, write US and India. I used to make a note of what all has happened between India and US in the last 1-2 years. But I used to start with a good opening line that could be used in all questions of India and US. This line I'll get in MEA website, Ministry of External Affairs website. A good opening line that could be used in any question. This, secondly, this will also give you a PDF file will be there. This will also give you the perspective of all the evolution, the various relationship between India and other countries, how it has evolved over a period of time, and how the present status is there. Using this ma'am's notes, you can get a historical perspective, context, historical perspective, and context you will get. In addition to this, whatever is there in the current affairs, whatever is there, any significant important thing has happened, you have to make that name of that issue. What I used to do was name of that issue, and if some scholars who have said something about this, at least two three scholars, scholar name views. This way I used to do for each and every country, and also all the topics that are mentioned in the syllabus. Along with this thing, since I had joined the test series helped me in active learning of the examination. I realized where my strengths are, I realized where my weaknesses is that, and by joining the test series, I was able to finish, cover the paper and that is questions in 3 hours. The reviews were very much helpful to me. It gave me more confidence. As I mentioned, in my first attempt, I was getting a score about 50 to 80, in the range of 50 to 80. Second attempt, I was getting 110 to 135. So there's significant improvement. The test series you must join. You must refer others' answers. Again, I'm repeating this. Others' answer. I, as an individual, may not be able to compete with someone who is an academician, but I am confident that I can definitely compete with someone who is writing for the civil services examination main of optional. Why do I say that? Because I have learned the master the art of answer writing through by referring others' answer and following the model answers given by the coaching institute. So by this way, we can ensure that we can score good marks in political science as option subject. Remember, once again I'm saying this, it's more about how well you manage your things, what you have read, and also more about how well you consolidate over a period of time. If you have made proper notes to the point, it will be very easy for you to revise them multiple times quickly and ensure that all the things that you have read is there in your mind, because ultimately what matters is how well you can remember things while you are writing the answer. Nobody will judge you how many number of books you have read, what all have you read. You will be judged by what you write. So ensure that you do some management, take extra effort than the crowd, so that you get a better decent score. And if you just take a normal effort, you may land up something to 242, 260. But if you do take some certain extra efforts, you may definitely score 300 plus easily. So by that way, I have secured the 304 marks in my both paper 1 combined and paper 2 combined. Thank you so much.